Hello everybody, it's Forever Sims. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another part of Let's Play Magical Diary. Okay, so we're in class right now. We gained 3 blue magic and 3 stress, doing good. We learned a spell. Farsight allows the caster to view a nearby known location. And we're moving on with our lives. Oh, we're doing blue magic again. I really don't remember what we were doing. So I'm just kind of getting thrown into this. We're doing gym. Oh, look at us getting so strong. We're killing the game, friends. Got 3 red magic. Okay, our red magic's doing pretty good now. Doing some green magic. Okay, our green magic is OP. It's all good. Oh no. I don't want to mess with this fool right now. Hello, Eliza. Did you enjoy your dinner? I suppose it was alright. Really? If you like your chili on the bland side. I actually don't like chili at all, so. I thought so. Okay. There are many secrets here you probably haven't found yet, such as the best place to get a good meal. Would you like to come to dinner with me tomorrow? Off campus? At the mall food court? He chuckles. Near the mall, but not quite part of it. It's called the Glen, and it's magic only. The professors go there when they're too tired to travel and visiting parents who want to take their student children somewhere nice. I thought parents weren't allowed to visit. Non-magical parents aren't supposed to visit. Triggered. So, would you like to go? Is this a date? I'm busy this week. I can't afford it. Does this mean you trust me? I'm busy, Damien. I don't like you. Sorry, I can't this week. I have other things I need to do. Oh. Well, how about next week then? I'd rather not. You don't want to be seen with me. Why you gotta make everything so dramatic? I just don't think it's a good idea for us to go out. No, of course you don't. This is your revenge. Why is he getting so savage on me? This is your revenge, little witch, wasting my time. What? Don't touch me. Okay, I don't. He twitches his arm away from my grasp and storms down the hall. Well, fine, be that way. Yeah, Eliza, you don't need to put up with that crap. So much for being friends. Yeah. I never wanted to be his friend, so. On Saturday morning, the mail and allowances are delivered. Ellen, there's a letter for you. Oh, it's from my family. Ellen carefully works her fingers under the sealed envelope flap, opening it with a minimum of tearing, then unfolds the letter and begins to read. What? She drops back onto her bed with a thud and stares at the paper in her hands. What is it?
It's nothing. Just a change of plans. Apparently I'm not going home for Thanksgiving.
What?
Because it's a long way for such a short break, so it's better for me to stay here.
Is that what you want?
That doesn't matter. Really, it doesn't. It's not my decision. I can't go home on my own. They don't want me there.
Well, we want you here, don't we, Eliza? Yeah. Come on, we should all do something together today. Yes, the squad.
You don't have to do that. I'm fine, really.
You're fine about not going home? What, do you hate your parents or something? Virginia, calm down.
I don't hate them. They just don't want me. Mama's probably glad to be rid of me.
What about your dad?
He's not around. I lived with my mama and Justin, my stepfather.
Your father left you?
Not exactly. Mama was... She left him with us because Jenny's my half-sister. Justin's her dad. My father was angry. I don't remember a lot of what happened. Then we moved and eventually he stopped writing. Mama says I look like him.
I'm sure they want to have you home. It's just, it's 800 miles. You're going home for Christmas, right?
As far as I know.
I feel so bad for Ellen. She's so precious. Her parents don't deserve her. Is it okay for people to stay here over the holidays?
Yeah, there's always someone staying. Some people don't want to have to go back being non-magical.
Hey, if you want, you can come to our house for the break.
Really?
Sure, we're used to having people stay over. Woohoo, I can read. I mean, I have to ask, but I'm sure it'll be alright. Virginia is me. tell them they can come over and then ask your parents. Unless you don't want to because, you know, my brother.
Oh, I'd rather be there than here all alone.
Okay, all right, Mom and Dad. Oh, Virginia's a good friend. Now let's go do something. Let's go outside. I want some fresh air.
Okay.
Cool. Hanging out with the squad. We go for a walk and eventually a run, which occasionally turns into a chase. I'm still the fastest. We have a good times, but we tire ourselves out a bit. Mm-hmm. Oh, next week. Let's go, guys. Okay, I'm ready. Flyers up in the halls have informed us that there will be a special assembly for all freshmen this Thursday. No class activities can be scheduled for that day. What should I do this week? All right, this is my least favorite part. Let's do black and white because they are the lowest. And then, our stress is at 19. We should probably sleep on the last day. And then before that, I guess we should maybe do blue. We need to also work on our smart and strong. No, we're gonna do this. Okay, cool. We're learning stuff. Hooray. This is just the funnest of times. Okay, what are we doing now? Blue magic? Blue. Success! Oh, darkness. Completely removes visibility in the caster's location. Why would you want that? I'm not really sure, but that's fine. Okay, on Thursday morning, all the freshmen are gathered together in the gym.
Good morning, my bright young things. Today is a special occasion for all of you. You're going to get to practice what you've learned and try out some spells on each other without the pressure of a test or grades. This is an important lesson because in future exams, you may come up against other spellcasters. You need to know how to use magic in combat and how to avoid magic being used on you. Will everyone please up in twos? Please team up in twos?
There's some jostling and shuffling around. Ellen and Virginia pair off, and I end up standing by Virginia's brother, Donald. That's the thing. When you have a friendship group of three, it's like someone's always left out. But it's fine because Bob Pancakes is our future husband, so.
Please pay attention before we begin. I want you to take turns casting spells at each other and blocking them. This is not a battle, and you're not trying to defeat each other. Think of it like a game of catch. One of you is the pitcher, and one of you is the catcher. You can only pitch when it's your turn, so defenders must only defend and not attack. Also, please don't interfere with any other pairs. That includes casting spells that tend to be messy. No fireballs or ice storms, please. Target only your partners. I will be on hand to deal with any injuries and accidents.
Okay, this just got dangerous.
If you hurt yourself, please call for help. I'll be right there.
Have fun. This sounds really sketchy. I turn to face my partner, my future husband, Bob Pancakes. What up, bro? Ladies first.
I'm not sure what to cast. I've never done this before.
You can do a push spell, right?
Sure, that's easy.
I fall into this trap where, like, both Donald and Eliza have the same voice, and it's just my voice, so.
Alright then, are you ready? I'll try and make Donald more masculine, it's fine.
3, 2, 1.
I start to cast the spell, but suddenly a wave of cold sweeps over my body and I can't move. The spell fizzles uncast.
Ha! I wasn't sure that would work. It'll wear off in a minute.
As he said, I unfreeze shortly, but my fingertips are still tingling and sore.
Alright, it's my turn now. Are you ready?
I suppose.
Uno, dos, tres. Why is he such a goofball?
Oh, we're supposed to counter, right? Like, so I guess we'll do this. There's a little jolt, and I feel a sting like a tiny electric shock as Donald stumbles backwards.
Ow!
Hey, you're not supposed to attack now.
I thought it might throw you off your aim?
I guess it might for a moment after. We work together for a while, trading spells back and forth. Then Donald holds up his hands and leans in close to whisper something.
I've got a great idea.
Idea. When I say go, you drop to the floor and cover your eyes. I'm gonna cast something over your head.
Okay.
Go. On cue, I duck and cover. There's a whooshing noise and a burst of heat overhead, followed by screams.
Donald, what are you doing?
Oh, you're in trouble. Well, your flaming dragon was very impressive.
I didn't get to see the flaming dragon. I'm so triggered right now. Oh, I missed the fire dragon. Eliza gets me, okay?
I did specifically tell you to avoid large spells. If poor Eliza hadn't managed to get out of the way, you would have hurt her badly. Like he cares. This is very disappointing. You've always been so careful in your creativity. Why would you take such a risk?
Oh no. Do we defend him? Let's defend him. He's our husband.
Professor Potsdam, I wasn't actually in danger. He told me to get down and made sure I was out of the way before he cast it. You knew what he was going to do.
Oh no. No, I didn't know. I didn't know that he was going to cast a fire dragon. He just told me to duck.
I knew he was going to do something, and saying this should get him out of trouble, right? Well, I suppose that changed things slightly.
Oh, look at me being a good wife. Detention for both of you, then? Okay. Son of a bitch.
What? It's only fair for both conspirators to suffer equally. And you did know that you shouldn't cast such large spells, but no demerits since there was no real danger.
God bless, okay? We just got in the green. I don't need any more demerits. Thank you.
Perhaps the two of you can use the time to come up with some more interesting ways of showcasing your skills for the class.
Yes, ma'am. No problem.
Try to be good now.
Oh, I love her. If Grabby was here, okay, we'd get a week's detention, 20 demerits, like our lives would be over, but thank God bless Professor Potsdam.
Jacob, put Miss Arias down.
Oh God, she hurries off to deal with someone else. Luckily, there are no major accidents for the rest of the session.
Well, thank freaking God. Sleeping reduces stress. Woo woo! Love my life. Oh no, Ellen is in the room, systematically taking clothes out of her dresser, then putting them back in.
What are you doing?
Folding my clothes.
Yeah, but why are you unfolding them first?
Because they aren't folded properly.
Okay. I guess everyone has their quirks. Aw, she's stressed about something.
Eliza, be more caring. On Saturday morning, the mail and allowances are delivered. I get up to go to my detention.
Detention again. Oh my God.
Miss Pancakes, Mr. Danson. Must I be forever burdened with this nonsense?
Since you are both being punished for the same offense, you will receive the same punishment.
He points to the tables where two very large glass jars filled with pebbles are sitting. You will each take one jar. You will take out each pebble individually by hand. You will place each pebble on the table, forming two separate stacks. After you remove each pebble, you will write down the total number of pebbles that were in the jar. You will then return the pebbles to your jar by hand. I have ways of detecting whether or not each pebble has been touched. Do not attempt to shirk.
Not sure what shirk means, but okay, Grabby.
Do you understand?
Sure.
And if your count is off or you attempt to pocket any of the pebbles, I will lock you in this room with no food or water until Monday.
Is that legal? Is my question.
I'm just saying. He stalks out of the room, closing the door behind him.
What's the point of this?
Boredom, that's all.
Great.
Sorry I got you into this.
You didn't. It was my decision.
I mean, it wouldn't have been right to let them think you were trying to hurt me when you weren't.
Yeah, well, I knew I was going to get busted for it, and I didn't warn you.
And I didn't warn you?
Oh, because he knew he was going to get in trouble.
I get it. If he knew he'd get in trouble, why'd he do it?
Sit across from Donald and smile at him.
Oh my God, my heart. Do you get tired of being in here every Saturday?
Hey, you noticed.
I don't think that's something you should be proud of.
Notice what?
That I'm here.
Well, that's sort of obvious, isn't it?
You'd think.
Beg your pardon?
He leans back in his chair and smiles.
Do you have any brothers or sisters?
Huh? No.
Do you want them?
Are
you offering? That's a little freaking weird. I think we're gonna continue this conversation in the next one.
Wow.
This is interesting. Okay. Yeah, we'll talk about this later. But thank you all so much for watching. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this part. I hope that you're all having a super amazing day, and I will see you in my very next video. Bye, guys.